Today we will discuss about lattice translation vectors. Before going to know about lattice translation vector, one must have idea about basis. What is a basis? A group of atoms is called a basis. Basis may contains also ions. In this basis, you have two different ions. A basis may contain one ion or may contain more than one atoms or ions. The set of mathematical points to which the basis is attached is called the lattice or space lattice. The set of mathematical points to which the basis is attached is called the space lattice. You see in this figure, these points are mathematical points, and in these mathematical points the basis can be placed, and these mathematical points are called lattice, or you may say space lattice. An ideal crystal is constructed by the infinite repetition of identical groups of atoms. You see in this figure, when in the mathematical points, that is the lattice, you placed this basis, and there is repetition of this basis, it is called the crystal structure. So an ideal crystal structure or crystal is constructed by infinite repetition of identical groups of atoms, or you may say identical basis. The lattice in three dimensions may be defined by three translation vectors, let us say A1, A2 and A3. You see in this figure, you have lattice points, and the lattice points are in three dimension. So the lattice is constructed in a three dimension, and the lattice in three dimension may be defined by three translational or translation vectors. A1, this is A2, and this is A3. The magnitude of this vector A1, A2 and A3 will remain same from whatever position you take the measurement, whether you take the measurement from here or you take the measurement from here. The magnitude of A1, A2 and A3 remains the same. That is, the arrangement of atoms in the crystal looks the same when viewed from the point, any point R, as when viewed from every point R dash translated by a vector which is an integral multiple of A1, A2 and A3. Suppose you take the measurement from O. O is the origin of your measurement system, and the lattice point is at this position at a distance R, and you want to find out or view the lattice from here. That is, whether you take the measurement from here or here, the crystal looks same. The crystal looks same whether you take the measurement from here or here, basing the origin from O, and there must be a translation vector. Okay. That is, in between R and R dash, there is a translation vector which is called lattice translation vector, so that the atom will look same whether you view the atom from here or here. If you take the triangle law vector addition, then R dash will be equal to R plus T. So here T is equal to U1 A1 plus U2 A2 plus U3 A3, where U1, U2 and U3 are arbitrary integers and t is called the lattice translation vectors. The set of points r dash defines the lattice. Then what is a primitive lattice? The lattice is said to be primitive if any two points from which the atomic arrangement looks the same satisfy equation 1, this equation, that is r dash is equal to r plus t. That is why the vector t is often called primitive translation vector. Okay, we often use the primitive translation vector to define the crystal axis, which form three edges and edges of the primitive parallelepiped. Non-primitive axes are often used as crystal axes when they have a simple relation to the symmetry of the structure. That is in crystal structure we use both primitive translation vectors and non-primitive translation vectors. The primitive translation vectors are basically used in primitive crystal structure, for example primitive unit cell, and non-primitive translation vectors are used in non-primitive unit cells or centered unit cells. We also use non-primitive translation vectors in case of structures like hexagonal crystal family, etc. So, what is a primitive unit cell? Primitive unit cell means when the constituent particles are present on the corners position of a unit cell, it is called the primitive unit cell. Okay. Suppose you have a simple cubic structure. In simple cubic structure, the atoms are present on the 8 corners. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 corners in simple cubic structure. That is why it is called primitive simple cubic. That means only atoms are present at the corners, and in this case the number of atoms per unit cell is equal to 1, because each atom is shared by 8 unit cells. So sharing of this atom per unit cell is equal to 1 by 8, and there are total 8 number of atoms. So number of atoms per unit cell, 1 by 8 into 8, that is equal to 1. So number of atoms per unit cell is equal to 1. Primitive unit cell are basically used primitive translation vectors are basically used in primitive unit cell, but non-primitive translation vector is used in non-primitive unit cell. So what is non-primitive unit cell? When a unit cell contains more than one atom per unit cell, it is called a non-primitive unit cell, or you may say a non-primitive unit cell, or you may say centered unit cell. For example, BCC, body centered cubic, face centered cubic, etc. You see, in body centered cubic, there are 8 atoms at the 8 corners, and there is a atom at the center, body center. So number of atoms per unit cell for the center, for the corner atoms, is equal to 1, because there are, I have explained you, this is these atoms, the sharing of this atom is just like the sharing in simple cubic. But for this body centered atom, the sharing of unit cube is equal to 1. So total number of atoms of BCC, body centered cubic, is equal to 2. Total number of atoms per unit cell is equal to 2. Again, in face-centered cubic, there are 8 atoms at the 8 corners, and there are 6 faces. For each face, for each atom on this one face, this atom is shared by 2 unit cells, this and the adjacent unit cell. So, sharing per unit cell is equal to half. Since there are 6 faces, So total number of atoms per unit cell will be equal to 1 by 2 into 6, that will be equal to 3, and number of atoms per unit cell for these corner atoms, is equal to 1. So total number of atoms per unit cell is equal to 4. So in summary, a lattice is an array of points related by the lattice translation operator T or lattice translation vector T. The lattice translation vector is useful for primitive lattices and non-primitive lattices.